The time, dawn. The date, December 29th, 1963. The town is Chicago, and the winds blow sharp with the edge of winter. But here today, the two best football teams in the world meet in a deadline to glory. Jet engines blow hot air, robbing the frost of its target, the turf. Even the pride of the Middle West, hay, has been used and must now be baled again and hauled back to the farm. But the bite of winter is nothing to these fans, here to see the championship of the National Football League. And for the man in the hat, this is truly a sentimental journey. The name is Halas, George S. Halas. He's coach of the Chicago Bears, champs of the West. Football he loves, and he plays to win with ruggedness like this. But to this man, the projection of the game is more than muscle and beef. He's Allie Sherman, coach of the New York Giants, boss of the NFL's Eastern Conference champions. He knows about the force and the object, the irresistible, the immovable, or in football, the attack and the defense. And for Y.A. Tittle, the league's premier passer, that's what determines who wins, who loses. For New York, irresistible force is in the arm, the hand of Tittle. Plus, of course, the reception committee. Del Schaffner, considered one of the finest split ends in the league. And flanker Frank Gifford. But against this, the Bears have a covey of burglars from the midway. Interception-hungry defenders like Benny McRae. And Dave Witzel, formerly of Indiana. With Richie Pettibone from Tulane. And Larry Morris, linebacker extraordinary. Oh yes, here's Ed Obradovich. A big reason the Bears met their big days of decision. As Vince Lombardi, coach of the Green Bay Packers, discovered when the Bears muffled his offense and romped all over his men to win a climactic game in the Western Conference. With the offense running like this, Chicago put out the fire in Green Bay and earned the right to meet the winner of the Steelers-Giants game, where New York won its conference title with one man's hand, Gifford's. Here's the spectacular evidence. Pittsburgh never could come back after Gifford's grab.
I think you're inclined more to pour up just a little bit, but the officials, a very capable crew, are out with the players now, the captains of the team coming out for the toss of the coin for the benefit of the crowd. We've already told you, I believe, that the Chicago Bears have won the toss. They will defend the south goal. We set the scene for you. We're on the west side. Schachter, the referee, he comes to this side, ready to blow the whistle. And it just matters. There it is, and the game is underway. It's a good long kick waiting for us. Is Martin. He takes it, fumbles the ball in the end zone, elects to come out with it. He's at the 5, gets to the 10, and down he goes from the 10-yard line. With Morris wide to the right, Carrington wide to the left, no score in the ball game. Wade wants to pass, no run for the ball. He's got a first down across the 20, up to the 23-yard line. Billy Wade rolled out, tipped downfield to pass, couldn't find anybody open, saw the hole and went for a first down, all the way from the 15-yard line up to the 23.
Jim, this is the type of football that Wade has played all year long. He ran his first two plays conventionally and then was back to pass on third down, saw an opening and ran for his first down. This is what they like to do.
The Bears, Johnny Morris is wide to the right. The running backs are Marconi and Willie Gallimore. Marconi's right behind the quarterback, Wade. Giants waiting. There's the handoff. Going with the ball is Gallimore, trying to go to the outside. He's tripped up by Barnes, the wingback who came flowing in to drop him as he fell forward on about the 24-yard line. We'll see where referee Norm Schachter marks the ball. Earage Barnes from the cornerback came flying in that time to spin him around as Gallimore then was pinned to the turf on the 24. A gain of a yard. It's second down and 9 yards to go. Marconi, Bill Wade calling the signals. Wade dropping back to pass. Now Alex run with the ball up the middle. He's got the first down at the 40. Fumbles the ball. Giants recover. Giants ball on the Bears 41. Let's see if we can pick up
number 49 recovered the fumble, and it's the Giants' ball in their territory. Twice on third down, Wade has been back to pass. That one looked like a diagram play. This was a quarterback running play. This time, Wade had his first down, but couldn't hold on to the football. Inside is Aaron Thomas, who's starting at the right end in the place of the injured Walton. Tittle back to throw on the 50, throws the screen to Morrison. He's at the 40, to the 35, down to the 30, and down he goes out of bounds at about the 29-yard line. The short pass to Morrison, and Morrison went inside the 30. We'll see where they marked the ball. They spotted it as they bring it in. They put it down on the 29. A gain of some 11 yards and a first down for the New York Giants.
And the screen pass, Jim, has been a big weapon for the Giants all year long. Kittle, I think, is probably the best at executing the screen pass of any of the quarterbacks.
To go. Del Schachter is putting out wide to the left. The running backs are King and Morrison. Morrison with the ball, driving up the middle. Morrison getting down to about the 20-yard line and a stand-up run, and tempers are flaring for the moment. We have 9 minutes, 27 seconds remaining in the first quarter. No score in this ball game as Joe Morrison does not get the first down. He's very close to it. He's just inside the 20-yard line. The New York Giants. Now, Gifford goes in motion. The ball goes to Tittle. He gives to Morrison. Morrison flies over the middle for a first down, down to about the 16-yard line. Joe Morrison up and over, right over his own left guard, down to about the 16 or 17-yard line before Larry Morris, the right linebacker of the Bears, came in to bring him down. A first down for the Giants, and the Giants now are down in scoring territory, down on the 16-yard line of the Chicago Bears. Wide from the left, Morrison is right behind Tittle. Tittle dropping straight back to pass, throws, and the flat, complete for a touchdown. Frank Gifford taking the throw from wide Tittle in the corner for a touchdown, and the Giants draw a first blood over the head of Benny McBrady. That score came with 7 minutes 38 seconds remaining here in the first quarter. Don Chandler trying for the punt after. Glenn Griffin holding. There it is. It's good. There's timeout on the field with a score of the Giants 7 and the Bears nothing. Margin all. The Tittle throwing to Gifford. There's the kick. It's a long kick. Waiting for it is Ronnie Bird. He is at the 10, the 15. Doesn't get a block as he tries to come to the outside and gets up to the 19-yard line, which brought down once again by Dick Lynch. The sure tackle for the New York Giants. It'll be first and 10 for the Bears on their own 19.
It'll be interesting here to see how the Bears approach attacking the Giant defensive unit, as they have played ball control all year long. Most of the time, they have been in control of the game.
They're down, 9 yards to go, score 7-0, Giants lead. Billy Wade once again dropping back to pass, throws a little flat pass out in the left to Marconi. Marconi finds his feet, he's at the 30, and down he goes on the 30-yard line. A little pass behind the line of scrimmage, and a nice gain as he got up to the 30-yard line before he was brought down by Jim Cannon. And the crowd here at Wrigley Field, naturally very much pro-Bears, cheer as the Bears pick up another first down. First and 10 for the Bears right on the 30-yard line. 20, waits for the pass from center. He gets it, boots it, a pretty good kick. Taking it is down. He's at the 25. Still his feet coming to this side, and down he goes on the 27-yard line. Eddie Dowd took the ball on the 25, and he was brought down hard on the 27 by Ted Karras, who was in on the kickoff team. A 39-yard punt, and now it's the New York Giants ball in their own 27. The Giants lose this ball game by a score of 7-0, as we have 4 minutes. Back to punt now as Don Chandler, standing on the 12, takes it. A beautiful, long, spiraling kick waiting for it is Johnny Morris on the 20. He comes to this side, gets to the 25, runs into his own man, and down he goes. It was Joe Fortunata that he ran into, and he ran into him hard. We'll see where they spot the ball as they bring it in. Looks like it's going to be on the 24-yard line. We pause now 10 seconds for station identification. Morris is extremely wide to the right. The right left end is in tight this time.
with the ball is Gallimore going to the outside. He's at the 25, gets to the 30, and is brought down. He fumbles the ball. Let's see whether the whistle blew before the fumble occurred. It looked like the Giants went in to recover, but the whistle may have blown before the fumble occurred. No, it's going to be the Giants' ball. Giants have it in Bear territory on the 31-yard line. First and 10, once again for the Giants, deep in Bear territory on the 31-yard line. They have held on to the ball consistently. We're in the first period, a minute 38 remaining. Score 7-0. Giants lead. And wide middle, it goes for a receiver in the end zone, and it is no good. In and out of the hands of Del Schaffner. Schaffner had clearly gotten by Witzel. He was in front of Witzel, and Tittle hit him with what appeared to be a perfect pass. It might have been just a touch high, but he got both hands on it and dropped it in the end zone. So it'll be second down and 10 yards to go.
About the only pattern that Y.A. Tittle has fallen into all season long is the fact that after a break such as this that just occurred, he will go for the touchdown on the first play. One of the reasons for his tremendous success, I think, is the fact that he has been completely unpredictable.
Rather tight on the left side, running backs are king as Tittle goes back to throw. Throws the short pass, intercepted by the Bears at the 30. He's at 50, the 49, the 40, may go all the way. Down to the 30, down to the 10, and down to the 5-yard line. Rory Morris intercepted and reached all the way down to the 5-yard line. Darryl Dess brought him down.
Former great
great player for the San Francisco 49ers. Now with Ellie Sherman and the Giants, and Eddie Dobb, who also was from the 49ers. The score here at Wrigley Field as we get ready to go into the second quarter, 7 for the Giants, 7 for the Bears. So we're starting all over again. Roger McClure standing down on the 25-yard line. McElhinney is on the 5. Eddie Dobb has moved up to about the 8. There's the whistle. There's the kick. Going in the direction of Dobb, who comes up to take it on the 14. Tries to go to the far side at the 20. He's going to his feet at the 25 at their 30. Swings across the 35 and up to the 37 or 38-yard line before he's brought down. A nice return from the 14 on the part of Eddie Dobb, who was brought down by Cadill on about the 37 or 38-yard line. We'll see where Norm Schachter spots that ball as he moves it inbounds to the inbound mark, and he puts it down on the 38-yard line. Score is 7-7. Giants ball on their own 38. Outside, the tight right end, calling the signals, is Y. Tittle. He gives to Morrison, and Morrison tries to go up the middle and gets a yard or two as he crosses the 40 and is brought down by Bill George, the middle linebacker, along with Stan Jones. Wide Tittle, as Schachter out wide to the right, dropping straight back to pass, throws, and it is complete to Aaron Thomas at the 30, out of bounds, across the far sideline. We'll see where he stepped out, as he got inside the 20 and down inside the 15, on about the 13-yard line. Aaron Thomas taking the pass across the field from Y.A. Tittle, and he just cakewalked on that far sideline. He kept his balance perfectly. As he went out of bounds, they say, on the 14-yard line, a fine catch and a great run after he caught the ball on the part of Aaron Thomas.
Thomas has taken the place of the regular tight end Joe Walton, and he has executed a pattern that's been good for the Giants all year long. They send Gifford and Schachter deep and cross Thomas underneath.
Switches over and goes to the right side. Tittle calling the signals. He gives to Morrison. Morrison goes to the outside, tries to go and count as he's brought down. He tried to cut to his right, saw that he couldn't go to the outside, cut back upfield, and is brought down by Doug Atkins, almost in the line of scrimmage.
Al Sherman, the coach of the Giants, is a great believer in going to the outside on the short yardage. He will many times on third and one, second and one, go with the end sweep, which he did that time, unsuccessfully with Joe Morrison.
Second down. Goal to go on the 3. Once again, it's Morrison with the ball coming to this side. He's at the 5, and down he goes to the 6-yard line. Morrison tried to come to this side, the wide side of the field, and he was followed beautifully by Ed Obradovich. And Obradovich brought him down to the 6-yard line, a 3-yard loss in the play. And that tough Chicago Bear defense that you've heard and read so much about now is beginning to display itself. It'll be 3rd down, 6 yards to go for the touchdown. 3rd and goal on the 6. Scoring position with 10 minutes remaining in the second quarter. Y. Tittle back to pass. Lee Rush, now he throws the middle floor pass over for King. A little pass out in the flat to King. King was on about the 8-yard line, but apparently he didn't turn quickly enough, or perhaps the ball hit him a little faster than he thought. It bounded out of his hands. Fortunato was right there with him. Chances are he wouldn't have been able to go in anyway. Don Chandler will come into the ballgame now on 4. This time it'll be from about the 13-yard line. Waiting for the pass from center. There it is. There is the kick, and it's perfect. Now, during the timeout, there's timeout in the field with the score of the Giants 10, the Bears 7. The Giants lead the Chicago Bears 10-7, and Don Chandler will kick off with Ronnie Bull and Billy Martin Deaton. There's the kick. It's a high kick, not particularly long, into the wind. Bull fumbles the ball, picks it up on the 12, looks for running room. He's at the 15, gets to the 20, and down he goes on the 21. Here is Barnes coming in to make the snap on the 21-yard line.
Jim, the north end of the field looks directly into the sun, and the last two kickoffs that have been received at that particular end, you remember Charlie Killett fumbled for the Giants, the Bears recovered, but
as he switches over, Thomas is in tight, calling the signals, Y. Tittle. Hands are up to King, and King breaks across the 45, the 50, and into their territory, down at about the 47-yard line. A good run on the part of Phil King, who broke off the right side of his line, the left side of the Chicago Bears, and got very close to a first down.
In an obvious passing situation, second and long, or third and long, Tittle is oftentimes going on to the draw play, which he did that time to King, and King runs it very well.
By Tittle was shot here to this side, Gifford to the far side. King and Morris and the running backs right behind him. He gives this time again to King, and King breaks across the middle, across the 40 now to about the 37-yard line. Bill King, on a play almost identical with the last one, went right down to the 47, and apparently the cagey Y. Tittle, Pat Summerall, is gauging that defense of the Chicago Bears very well.
The Bears, as I pointed out a moment ago about Tittle, who has never gotten into a consistent pattern, the Bear defense has not patterned itself either.
The Bears, possessed of the New York Giants, here in the second quarter with the Giants leading, and once again they're threatening. Tittle back to throw, throws long, and it is caught, but is he in bounds? Nope, he's out of bounds. Line. Quite a number now of the Giants. Well, McElhinney he is staying in there. He's wearing tennis shoes. 6 yards to go. Wide to the right is Frank Gifford. As Shepard is in tight. Back to throw is Tittle. He's hit just as he throws the ball to Morrison. Down he goes. Morrison is at the 40. Down to the 35-yard line. Fumbles the ball, and I believe the Bears recovered. Let's see whether the whistle blew first. Whistle may have blown. I believe it did, as the Bears picked up the ball on the 35-yard line. Tittle was racked up pretty hard as he threw that, got rid of that ball on a pass behind the line of scrimmage to Morrison. Morrison, with a good effort, got down to the 35-yard line. And the Chicago Bears do not get that ball. The Giants retain possession. Second down, 10 yards to go. Tittle once again back to throw. Looks for Schaffner. It's intercepted. Intercepted by number 22, Damon Butler. And it's the Bears ball on about the 26-yard line. Whistle took the pass intended for Del Schaffner, and it's the Bears' ball on their own 26. Score here in the third. Billy Wade in the quarterback will check that offensive lineup in a second. The screen pass for Marconi. Marconi's at the 30, 35, gets the 40, still at his feet at the 45, and down he goes at the 45. A scramble for the ball. Let's see who recovered it. He held on to it. Marconi held on to it at the 45-yard line. So it's a gain from the 26 to the 45 of 19 yards. Brought down by Mickey Walker and Dick Mozeleski, or rather Sam Hunt, number 70, and Mozeleski bringing him down in the 45. Listen to this crowd. Letting the signals wait on second down, 10 yards to go. They're ball on their own 45-yard line. They trail in the ballgame by a score of 10-7. On the long count, Wade dropping straight back to pass, throws down the middle. It's complete to Marconi at the 30, down to the 25, down to the 20-yard line. Chicago Bears pick up 34 yards on the play from their own 45 down to the New York Giants 21-yard line as they've gone into an all-out pressing pass attack. They had a 5-minute. So it'll be a 28-yard effort on the part of Roger McCare. There's a pass in center. There's the kick. It's long enough. Is it through there? It's no good. It's wide. Wide to the left, and the Giants retain their lead, 10-7. And so we're having thrills galore. The tremendous run back of the opening kickoff of the second half by Hugh McElhenney, and the Bears storming back downfield but not able to get a tally. They trail in the ball game, 10-7, as we have 11 minutes, 31 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. Y.A. Tittle, Joe Morrison, Hugh McElhenney, Frank Gifford. The ends are Schaffner and Walden. Both ends are in tight. Only Gifford is wide to the right. As Tittle goes back to throw, it's being rushed. Throws, and it's intercepted by Obradovich. Obradovich intercepts, races down to the 15-yard line of the Giants. Signals Billy Wade on second down, 10 yards to go. He gives this time to Ronnie Bull, who comes to the right. He is still in his feet down at about the 12-yard line, and down he goes. Barnes coming in from the secondary to belt him hard as Ronnie Bull tried to get to the outside. But here it's Barnes cut off the avenue and dropped him down at about the 13-yard line. So it's third down and about 9 yards to go. We have 3 minutes, 37 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. The score, the Giants 10, the Bears 7. Substitution coming in for the Bears as Roger Davis, the former All-American from Syracuse, replaces Cadill at the left guard. Farrington, who's in at left end, goes extremely wide to the left. Morris is wide to the right, calling the signals Billy Wade, with Marconi right behind him. Wade throws the pass complete inside the 5 to Ditka. He's down to the goal line. Very close to a touchdown is Mike Ditka. Ditka taking the throw right over the center, gets down for a first and goal down at about the 1 yard line. Heffernan and Patton come in to make the stop. On that play, Bill Wayne straightened up, and he hit Ditka with a quick looking pass right down on the 2-yard line. So it's first and goal now for the Bears on the Giants 2. Out of the huddle come the Bears. Morris once again wide to the right. Billy Wade on second down, goal to go, waiting for that handoff. Probably will take it in this time, and the quarterback sneaky does for a touchdown. Touchdown with David Whitzel holding. Here's the pass and center. There's the kick. It's good. There's time out on the field with the score. The Bears 14, the Giants 10. 15-yard line. Dove and McElhinney are down in the 5. Referee Norm Schachter getting all set to kick off. Here it is. Good high kick down the middle. Take waiting for it as Dove takes it on the 5. He's at the 10, the 15, to the 20, to the 25. Still in his feet at the 30. But down he goes on the 31-yard line. Ripping hard to the ground by Larry Glick. Larry Glick, number 43, along with Billy McRae, bringing him down on the 31-yard line. So it's first and 10 now for the Giants on their own 31-yard line. Chicago Bears have taken the lead. They lead by a score of 14-10 as we're in the closing moments of the third quarter for the World Championship of Football. Out of the huddle come the New York Giants. Second down, 10 yards to go. Kittle hands off to Morris, and Morris finds the hole. He's at the 40, 45, and up the midfield, down to the 49-yard line, and he almost went the distance. Only Rosie Taylor could get him. He got him around the ankles as Joe Morrison displayed a great deal of speed as he burst into the open and almost went all the way. He got to the 49-yard line of the Bears. A good gain from the 31 of the Giants to the 49 of the Bears at 20 yards. Beautiful call on the part of Y. Kittle as the Bears had the rush on that time, and he handed off to Morris, to Morrison, who found the hole. Kittle wants to get back to throw. Throws long for Thomas, and it's broken up by Pettibone. Richie Pettibone came in and almost intercepted. And Pat, once again, this Bear defense in the secondary is pretty much all we heard about it, too.
It certainly has been tremendous this afternoon. The defense has actually set up both of the Bear touchdowns. That time, it appeared that Pettibone had picked that one off, but I think, again, the sun was a factor.
14-10. It's the Giants ball in Bear territory on the 49-yard line. Second down, 10 yards to go. Calling the signals, Y. Kittle, who was injured early in the ball game, but he's been in there throughout the second half. Kittle once again back to throw. Looks downfield. Throws long for Gifford. Gifford is tripped up, and they're not going to call it a penalty. We thought for a minute it might be. Gifford looked up, but apparently they tripped up over each other. He and the defender as they went for the ball. The official came in as though he were going to throw the flag. Then he shook his head and said no. He was right out of the play. Wide to the right. Webster, McElhinney are the running back. Kittle back to throw. Standing in the 40, being right. Throws down the middle. No good. Del Shopka, the intended receiver. The defender was David Whitson. 3 seconds remaining. The unofficial time indicated on the scoreboard clock. So it'll be fourth. That's correct, Pat. I can't remember either. Here's Don Chandler ready to boot. A pretty fair kick, but not one of Chandler's best. Taken on the 18-yard line, and down he goes in the 19, Morris. And that is the end of the third quarter. The third period of today's championship game has been brought to you by Marlboro. If you're thinking of trying a filter cigarette, try the flavor brand Marlboro. 1-yard kick on the part of Bobby Joe Green. Y.A. Kittle, along with McElhinney, Morrison and Gifford in the backfield. As the ball goes to Morrison, Morrison gets away from tacklers at the 40 and fights his way up to about the 45. He was belted hard by Rosie Taylor. Actually, Taylor carried him for a yard or two toward the Bear goal line as he peeled back to make the tackle, and it appeared as though Morrison was going to twist out of the grasp of one of the Bear tacklers. But he hit him hard. The Bears have Obradovich,
Jones, Atkins, and Johnson now in at the front as Fred Williams is out of the ballgame. It's second down and about 4 yards to go for the Giants on their own 45. Calling the signals is Wyatt Tittle with Gifford Wyatt to the right. He gives the ball to Morrison. Morrison fumbles. There's recovery. Calling the signals. He gives the ball. Ball gets to the 50. Fights his way down to the 45-yard line before he's brought down by number 70, Sam Huff. Ronnie Bull took the handoff from Wade, came to this side, cut up field, and got inside the 45. A good 6 or 7 yard gain before he's brought down. It'll be second down at 3 yards to go. And the Chicago Bears with Koya, Bull, Harris, Pyle, Cabillo, Wataska, Ditka, Morris, Wade, and Marconi. In their lineup, Ken Morris wide to the right. Coy is wide to the left. The running backs are Marconi and Bull. Morris is wide to the right. Farrington is wide to the left. The ball goes to Wade. Back to throw. Throws for Morris, and he hangs on to it at the 40 and goes out of bounds on about the 43-yard line. Out of bounds on about the 47. Eric Barnes drives him out as Johnny Morris hung on to that ball that time. On the pass across the field, they passed to the far side of the field, the wide side, and got Morris inside the 40, down to about the 38-yard line. So it's first and 10 for the Chicago Bears, and now the Bears leading the Bears ball, second and 4 on the Giants' 33-yard line. Billy Wade calling the signals on the long count. Once again, he's checking off of that line. He hands the ball. Bull gets across the 30, picks up a first down as he's down to the 28-yard line. Dick Pessinen and Eric Barnes come in to make the stop. But the forward line now of the Chicago Bears beginning to open up holes in the Giants' defense. Johnny Morris is wide to the right. Calling the signals is Bill Wade. Right behind him is Mark Coney. Right to his right is Ronnie Bull. The ball goes to Bull, and Bull is dropped. Robicelli got him first. Back of the line of scrimmage. As they umpire will check some of the other tacklers. But it was Robicelli who hit him first, Al Gursky, who came in, as Pat Summerall pointed out to you, when Tom Scott was shaken up. Roger LeClaire will try a field goal from 34 yards out. It's a straightaway shot. There's the kick. It's certainly long enough as it threw there. It's wide. It's no good. Wide to the right. So the Giants will take over on their own 20-yard line. Roger LeClaire booted that ball with plenty of distance. It was high, but it was wide. The Giants take over on their 20, and so with 8 minutes, 22 seconds remaining, the Chicago Bears, with their great defensive team, has stopped them pretty well so far. Morrison with the ball, goes to the outside, gets to the 35, up to the 37-yard line before he's brought down. Johnson, along with Larry Morris, Johnson the tackle, Morris the linebacker, bringing him down, and Morrison is hurt. Morrison is injured on the play and is very slow getting to his feet. He's going out of the ball game, and it looks like Ellie Webster will come in, number 29. Gain of 7 yards on the play. It's second down, 3 yards to go. 7 minutes, 53 seconds remaining in the ball game. Bears lead it. Summerall, the score, the Bears 14, the Giants 10. The Giants fall on their own 30-yard line with 7 minutes, 12 seconds remaining in the ball game. Y. Tittle going back to pass, looks downfield, throws long. And it's over the head of the intended receiver. Dell Schachter, who had gotten behind both David Witchell and Rosie Taylor, but the pass was over his head.
He had run Morrison first on the off-tackle slant and then Webster on the off-tackle slant for the first down, and I had the feeling that he was setting something up, and this time he ran the play pass off the same running play fake and tried to hit Schachter.
McRae moves over with him defensively. Right behind Tittle. Tittle fumbles the ball. Let's see who recovers. I believe the Giants did on the 32-yard line. Y. Tittle recovered his own fumble. Ball bounced, and Y. Tittle is limping now noticeably as he goes back into the huddle. We'll point out again to those of you who may have joined us a little bit late that Y. Tittle was injured in the second quarter. He left the ball game as apparently he injured his left knee with the exception of the field goal. The defense has set up all of the scores so far.
Tittle back to throw. Looks down the middle. Throws to Webster at the 45. He's at midfield for a first down for the Giants at midfield. Brought down by Johnson. That's why Tittle spun out, went back, and fired the ball to Alec Webster on a key play up to midfield. So with 6 minutes remaining here in the ballgame, the New York Giants have a first down at midfield. They trail in this ballgame 14-10, and the Chicago Bears of George Halas are digging in to try to stop them. And it's second down, 10 yards to go for the Giants at midfield. Tittle calling the signals. Hands off to McElhenney and McElhenney. Webster, rather, and Webster is dropped immediately. Alec Webster is dropped for a loss. Back on the 48-yard line. Across the way, Allie Sherman, the youthful coach of the New York Giants, looking on intently, wondering whether or not the Giants might be able to keep this drive going. And down below us, directly below us, is third down, and 12 yards to go. Tittle back to throw, looking downfield, throws for Gifford. Gifford has it out of bounds, on about the 36-yard line. A clutch catch by Frank Gifford for a first down. It was Gifford who 2 weeks ago up at Yankee Stadium against the Pittsburgh Steelers made a sensational one-handed catch that most of the reporters and the coaches later said was the key play of the ball game. And Gifford now made a great catch with 4 minutes 59 seconds remaining in this ball game, down in the 36 to be a touchdown. Score is 14-10. That's right, Patrick. It will not do any good. They've got to get the touchdown. Tittle once again back to throw. Looking downfield, throws for Thomas, and it's over his head. Terrence Thomas had gotten in the open. The pass was just over his head. I believe that Pettibone with Thomas probably delayed his last-minute charge for that ball. They were both going for it. It appeared as though Pettibone thought the ball would be too long, and he slowed up. But Thomas went for it, but couldn't get to it. Fred Williams comes out of the ball game for the Chicago Bears. We'll use up this other down to try to pick it up. Wide Tittle dropping straight back to pass. Puts downfield, throws long. He's hit just as he throws the ball. It's up in the air and intercepted. It's intercepted by the Bears, who have taken it in the end zone. It was Vinny McGrain who intercepted the ball. And Wide Tittle was hit by Morris just as he threw the ball. And it was up there for grabs, and McGrain came up with it.
And Jim, this boy Larry Morris has certainly done an outstanding job as a Bear linebacker today. He jumped completely over the offensive blocker who was assigned to him, and he's the fellow responsible for that pass interception, although McCray did make a great play.
Morris, Dipka this time is in sight. Morris is the flanker back. Bull and Marconi are the runners. With the ball is Ronnie Bull. Gets away from one tackle, back of the line of scrimmage. Another on his feet at the 25 and 30 and out of bounds. Across the way. What a good carry for a first down by Ronnie Bull as he goes out of bounds on about the 33 or 34-yard line. We pause now 10 seconds for station identification.
810 on your radio dial, WGY, WGFM, Schenectady.
The ball is on the 35-yard line of the Bears. Second down, 8 yards to go. The Giants' defense has been strong all day, holding. Bringing into the opening Bull as he gets to about the 39-yard line, and down he goes. Ronnie Bull, who took the ball, just stepped over the line and then turned with a burst of speed to go up to about the 39 or 40-yard line before Barnes and Cat Cabbage came in to make the stop. 2 minutes, 27 seconds remaining in the ball game. It's third down. They will try to get it if they can. Then, as Pat Summerall just remarked, they might be able to ride it out. If not, they'll have to punt. Bill Wade calling the signals, waiting for the handoff. He gets it, gives, and the carry is by Bull, who I believe picks up the first down. Ronnie Bull, and I believe he got that first down. It's very, very close. Maybe not. He came straight ahead. There'll be an official timeout, and this will be a very important measurement for both the Giants and the Bears. Ronnie Bull, the former All-American from Baylor, came right off his own right tackle. See whether he picked up that first down as they commence for the measurement. The headlines, if you hear a tremendous roar go up, I just won't say anything. You'll know it's a first down. If we have silence, it won't be. And it's not a first down. Bobby Joe Green standing back in the 29 yard, a high pass from center. He boots it. Not a particularly good kick. Bounces on the 30, inside the 25. Down and inside the 20. Rules
as it's going to be down as the Bears are down there watching it roll dead on about the 17-yard line. That was not a very long kick. However, once again, it had the momentum and the overspin to take it down. The score is 14-3. And they've got to score a touchdown to win this ballgame. The field goal won't do them any good. Wide Tittle back to throw. Throws down the slot. It's complete. The ball carrier is Thomas, and Thomas is down on about the 26-yard line. Actually, he was up to about the 28. He tried to peel back to find running room, and the Chicago Bears dropped him on the 26. An official timeout for a measurement. Crowd is booing. They didn't like to see that stop. The clock stopped. However, Norm Satcher wanted to call for the measurement, and he called for it, stopping the clock with a minute 24 seconds remaining in the ball game between the Chicago Bears and the New York Giants, with the Bears leading by a score of 14-10. It's their first down. 14-10. Wide Tittle has Gifford wide to the right. Schopner is wide to the left. Morrison and McElhenney are right back of him. Gifford back to throw. Looking down the slot. Throws complete to McElhenney. He is at the 35. Trying to run to get out of bounds, and he can't do it. And he's dropped on the 34-yard line. Hugh McElhenney obviously wanted to find that sideline and find it quick. He wanted to stop the clock. Now the Giants call timeout. It's the last timeout for the Giants. 3 yards to go. Wyatt Tittle dropping back to pass. Looks down, throws complete once again to McElhenney. McElhenney turns the corner and goes up to the 45-yard line. No timeouts remaining as McElhenney struggles to get away from the Bears to come to his feet. And the big burly Chicago Bears are in no hurry to let him have that opportunity. But out of the huddle come the Giants. 44 seconds remaining. Tittle back to throw. Being right, throws long for the sideline. It's no good. Intended for Morrison. Tittle was belted hard as he let that ball go by Doug Atkins. The clock stops with 39 seconds remaining. The score is 14-10. What a finish to a ball game. It's been a tremendous one here this afternoon. We have seen just about everything. Great defensive play. The touchdowns, both of the Chicago Bears, were set up by intercepted passes. One by Larry Morris, who raced 65 yards to set up their first score. The other by Obradovich. And the Giants' first touchdown was set up by a recovered fumble on the Bears' second down on the 45-yard line. Tittle back to throw. Looks down the sideline. Throws, and it's complete, but is it out of bounds? It was out of bounds to Gifford. Gifford caught it, but he was ruled out of bounds. He was right on the sideline. So we waited to see whether or not that was ruled out of bounds as he caught it. It was. And it's now third down. And 10 yards to go. 32 seconds remaining. The Giants trailing the Bears 14-10. Third down, and they've got to have a first down to continue the drive. Chicago Bears have five halfbacks in on defense, expecting the all-out passing attack. Tittle throws. It's complete to Gifford, and Gifford is belted immediately. But he breaks away from the tackler, Pettibone, who hit him hard. It was Vinnie McRae, not Pettibone, who hit him. McRae dropped him on the 40. Out of the huddle he comes, 17 seconds remaining. Tittle once again back to throw. Looking downfield, throws out of bounds. Intended for Gifford. And the out-of-bounds pass stops the block. And the case is Ryan Tittle, with 10 seconds showing in the ballgame, is giving this crowd a tremendous thrill. The Bears lead the Giants by a score of 14-10. It'll be second down. Giants, but the clock so far today has been very close. Out of the huddle they come. Calling the signals wide. Tittle, Gifford wide to the right. Tittle back to throw. Has pretty good protection. Throws long. It's going to be over the head and maybe intercepted by Pettibone. He's got it. Pettibone intercepts in the end zone. And this ball game will be all over. This is Pettibone. He intercepts in the pass. Wide Tittle is throwing his helmet on the ground. Banging it on the turf. But Richie Pettibone came up with that ball in the end zone. And the ball game with 2 seconds remaining will beat the Chicago Bears. No question about that. There's still 2 seconds showing, but this ball game is all over because the Bears will never run a play. They'll just run out that clock. Wade, I'm sure, will just take that ball and hold it. And the Chicago Bears, leading by a score of 14-10, as the defense of the Bears, that was another opportunity to throw, but Pettibone intercepted the end zone. Wade waiting for the handoff, counting off. He'll take it, just drives into the center of the line, and that's the end of the ball game. That's the end of the final score, the Chicago Bears 14.